Just 9 days after the shooting, Derek Englund stood in the middle of the ice here at T-Mobile Arena and made a commitment to Las Vegas. He said that the Golden Knights would do everything in their power to help our community heal. And on this third anniversary of 1 October, the team continues to make good on that promise.
Derek, getting to know him a little bit over the last few years, he's pretty reserved, you know, and it certainly you would not think he would be the person to stand in front of 18,000 people and give that speech, but he nailed it.
9 days after the worst mass shooting in our country's history, the Vegas Golden Knights had their first regular season home game. A city in desperate need of hope, the team meeting the moment.
Sports can help a little bit heal. You know, even if your other 22 hours a day are not fun and you're dealing with incredible pain, maybe for a couple of hours, the team and a game can be a bit of a diversion for you.
But what the Vegas Golden Knights did on the ice in 2017 and 2018, making it all the way to the Stanley Cup final, was only part of how they've served the community. With time, money, and advocacy, the team has and continues to have a positive impact.
We already knew that the Vegas community is very giving, but we were astonished when about a week and a half ago, we were working with the Golden Knights to open up this blood drive, and it was booked solid within about 2 or 3 hours.
Jennifer Sparks with the American Red Cross says partnerships like this one with the Vegas Golden Knights are critical to maintaining a stable blood supply. Even more so during a pandemic, which she says has forced the cancellation of drives and has been otherwise disruptive to the supply. On this somber third anniversary, the Vegas Golden Knights are stepping up, ensuring our community is always Vegas stronger.
I think that bond between the team and the community was forged by those horrendous events, but I don't see that ever being broken.
Now, the team's commitment to community does not end here at T-Mobile Arena today. The players are actually out delivering meals and flowers and other gifts to first responders across our city. Reporting, Jackie Kostek, 13 Action News.